once a person believes in La ilaha illallah wa Muhammadan Rasulullah, there is no social, political, or economic condition that can turn them away from this logical truth. There is nothing worthy of worship and obedience except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and Muhammad is his last and final messenger. To believe thus is natural as well as intellectual. To reject this kalima after once professing it, you must have done bumped your head.
لا يحل له أن يرتد عن الإسلام فإن فعل ذلك فحكمه القتل.
But what is the penalty for apostasy? What is the penalty for leaving the Muslim?
If it's an Islamic country, then the Sharia is very clear. Apostasy is dealt with the death penalty.
Thank you. That's all I want to hear.
This is just the beginning of a very, very large movement in defense of humanity. We want to break the taboo that comes with renouncing Islam. Apostasy, as our other speakers have mentioned, is a crime that is punishable by death in countries ruled by Islamic law. But it's not only in those countries. People who are deemed apostates are intimidated and threatened, even in countries, in Europe, for example, that doesn't have Islamic law as the law of the land. I've already received quite a number of interesting emails from Islamists, and one of them says, a Muslim is always a Muslim. It is not possible for us to leave Islam. Well, I have to tell him and many others, watch us, watch us, watch us, watch us.
My name is Aziz. I am an ex-Muslim.
I'm an ex-Muslim.
I'm an ex-Muslim.
I am an ex-Muslim.
I'm an ex-Muslim.
I'm an ex-Muslim.
I am an ex-Muslim.
I am an ex-Muslim.
Hi, my name is Islam, and I'm an ex-Muslim.
أنا مرتد عن الإسلام.
Hi, this is Kathleen Hai from the forum. I was growing up as a Muslim from a Bengali background in the southeast of the UK. I was quite a religious person. These days I just follow the tradition more out of respect, just live pretty much an atheist lifestyle. So that's me.